let's take a look at the user interface of SOLOstudio and SOLOstudio PRO. Now they're pretty much identical, even across platforms. I'm using an iPad, so I'm using the iOS version of the app, but it is pretty much the same on an Android device as well. And that goes across both mobile phones and tablets. Now you can see in the top left-hand corner, the first thing we're gonna look at is that little cog icon, and that opens up the main app settings. Now inside here, you can see on the left-hand side and the left column, we have app settings, the master fade out, we then have the pro features level shift, play pause, and next button. We go into those in a bit more detail in a later video. And on the right-hand side, we have what's called the default track settings. These are the default settings applied to any tracks imported after changes have been made to this section. So you can see I have fade in and fade out activated. You can also change the volume, delay, loop, and override. Now you can set these up however you like, but it means every time you bring in a new track, it will automatically have those settings applied, saving you loads of time. So for example, if I was to add a new track, I'd go to the top right-hand corner and press the plus symbol. That will open up your file browser, navigate to where you store your tracks. I have a folder on my iPad called Music Tracks, and I'm gonna import some songs. So let's say let's go for ABBA. Sorry about the music choices. Now you can see automatically that that tile has been imported into SOLOstudio, created this little square, which now allows us to queue that music track. You can see the small icons underneath the name of the track give us the fade in, and you can see overrides activated and the fade out as well. So you can see immediately that that's working. If you press the little cog icon inside a track tile, it will open up the settings for that track. And as you can see, all of those settings that we set just a few moments ago in the default track settings have been applied to this track. We'll go into that in a bit more detail in a video later on. Let's carry on with the UI. In the bottom left-hand corner, you can see there's a red X. That refers to the master fade out or panic mode. That will basically cause all tracks that are playing to fade out. That can be set again in the app settings by pressing that cog in the top left corner. Next to the red X, we have the play pause button. That only becomes active when a track is playing, because obviously you can only pause a track that is playing. So for example, if I was to start playing ABBA by tapping that tile, you can see the pause button immediately becomes active and I'm now able to pause it and play. This is also a feature that's built into the Pro settings where you can assign an RFID tag to that function. Next to the play pause, we also have a little speaker volume symbol that is associated with level shift, another Pro feature, which you can assign an RFID tag, which allows you to take volume levels up and down with just the toggle of one RFID tag. Next to that, then we have this big section, which is the play bar, which is fully responsive and will change in size depending on the other icons that are either side of it, depending on which version of SOLOstudio you're using and how many devices you have connected. And then finally, on the right-hand side, we have the little device icon. Now, in that bottom right-hand corner, the little mobile phone, when tapped, will open up a menu which shows you your paired devices on the list on the left and your available devices in the top right. In the bottom right-hand corner, there's also a little support section, which you can join our Solo Community Facebook group. You can obviously view video tutorials like this one, and you can also visit our website to look at the FAQs. And that is simply the user interface of SOLOstudio. It's incredibly simple to navigate, and hopefully that has been a bit of a quick start guide on how this looks.